Welcome on into the recruiting roundup. I'm Jordan Hamm, and we have plenty of guys coming off the board, plenty of commitments to get to on this edition of the recruiting roundup. With that, I'm going to bring in my good buddy, Jason Jewell. And Jason, we have five commitments to get to. Let's start things off with Spencer Brash, who commits to Cal.
Yeah, the quarterback over at Higley High School took advantage of the new rule where you're allowed to take official visits now during the spring and summer. That rule was just enacted last year by the NCAA. Takes a visit up to Cal, was the only one he took, and he makes commitment while he is on that official visit. Brash is a kid that we saw completely blow up through the spring evaluation period, was close to 20 scholarship offers after college quarterback coaches were able to come out and watch him throw. You look at a player like Brash, yes, he's a pocket passer, but I think he's a good enough athlete that when things break down, he can extend plays, and he's good enough that in certain situations where, you know, he's athletic enough where he can make, you know, make runs and be effective in the run game.
Yeah, 850 yards for him rushing last year for the Knights. So definitely can use those legs as well as that arm. Now, Jason, I know you love the guys in the trenches. We have three commitments for a couple of linemen.
It makes a big difference going out to some of these college camps where two of these guys were guys that didn't really have scholarship offers and ended up getting scholarship offers at these college camps. The first one is Roman DeWise over at Basha High School. Big kid, 6'4", 290 pounds is what he weighed in at Arizona State's camp. And then even more impressive, he ran a 5.15 on the laser in the 40-yard dash at that camp. Then he came back to one of their big man challenges and looked fantastic out there, received a scholarship offer from the Sun Devils, and very quickly, a day or two later, turned around and committed the first in-state commitment for Arizona State. No other scholarship offers. ASU jumped out and took a shot on him, but he's a guy that I like. He's a project down the road where you look at his film now, he tries to finish. He's got the tools. I think he's a guy down the road that ends up contributing a lot for the Sun Devils.
And then keeping it in-state, U of A picks up a commitment from Jordan Morgan from Marana.
Yeah, Marana High School offensive tackle, sleeper kid, 6'5" and about 270 pounds. I saw him at Arizona State's camp. I saw him at NAU's camp. He was very, very impressive up at NAU. Got scholarship offers from the Lumberjacks and from the Arizona Wildcats. We were at the camp as well. Didn't take him very long to pledge to the Wildcats. So he had those two offers plus an offer from South Dakota State. But when you get an offer from the Pac-12, it's pretty certain that those kids are going to take that commitment. Another big raw kid that camped and it paid off for him, and I like the commitment for the Wildcats.
And one of the biggest offensive linemen who's blown up this spring, Jacob Golden out of Peoria, he makes his commitment to Boise State.
Yeah, so one, I think this is a very good get for Boise State. You know, Golden is a player that was a tight end, H-back type player as a freshman, sophomore on varsity, moved to offensive tackle as a junior, and he's still growing, still developing. He's 6'6", he's 285 pounds now, but he wasn't always that big. He was more in that 220, 230 range a couple years ago and has really worked really, really hard to add the weight that he needs to compete at that level. Took an unofficial visit up to Boise State, had other offers from Washington State and most of the other mid-major programs in the Mountain West, but you know, it was the Boise State Broncos that he fell in love with. Talked to him, talked to his dad. He's very firm in that commitment. I don't think anyone's going to go and flip this kid.
And wrapping up the commitments, we have Carter Wheat from Red Mountain. He makes his commitment to BYU.
Yeah, we've seen BYU do a great job in the state, most recently getting a very high-profile prospect, Jacob Conover, at Chandler High School, but they get another one in Carter Week. The big tight end, Red Mountain High, is a guy that I was a big fan of, and I was surprised that through the spring evaluation period, he didn't have a scholarship offer. It just shocked me because I really like his film. I think he's a traditional Y. He'll put his hand down on the ground, and he'll block you, and he's effective enough in the passing game to be a threat out there. Got that scholarship offer from BYU. Took him about a day to make that commitment. His father played there and played in the NFL for a little bit. So I'm pretty expected that when he got that offer, it was his dream offer, and he took it.
It's been a busy summer, and plenty of more commitments I'm sure are going to be happening over the next couple of weeks. Make sure to keep it here on the Recruiting Roundup on Sports 360 AZ. Need my coffee, I guess. All right.